Welcome to the worship service at the Kirk of Kansas City. It's the 20th Sunday after Day of Pentecost. It's World Communion Sunday, and it's October 6th. We're glad to be connected with our online participants, Marilyn McDowell of Olathe and Pat Termini of Overland Park, and many others are faithful online participants. World Communion Sunday celebrates our oneness in Christ with our siblings in Christ all around the world. The nearest congregations to us here are South Point Church of Christ, St. Peter and All Saints Episcopal Church, Redbridge United Methodist, and probably a bunch of house churches that we don't even know about. One of the farthest congregations from us is Église Notre-Dame du Vent, a Catholic church on an island in the South Indian Ocean, Our Lady of the Wind. It makes sense, doesn't it? Breads of different ethnic origin are on the Lord's table, which has been generously set. When we celebrate, come forward as you like by way of the inner aisles. Eat the bread in front of the server. Gluten-free wafers and gluten-free bread will be nearby at that time if you prefer. Then please take the cup of juice, hold it in your hand, and return to seating by way of the outer aisles. When all have been served, we will share in the cup. Online participants, you may wish to have the elements of bread and juice nearby. Photos of blessing of the animals are now on the church bulletin board. Thank you so much, Dennis Rendina. Today we are receiving the last offerings to be directed to this year's Peace and Global Witness offering of the Presbyterian Church USA. This afternoon, our neighbors of the Glen Arbor Homes Association are meeting on the church grounds for their annual picnic. Tuesday, the service team meets at 2 p.m. in the library. Thursday, Kirk volunteers are doing a shift at Harvester's Food Network. Saturday, it's the Center Education Foundation Run Walk and the South Kansas City Block Party at Redbridge Shopping Center. Also Saturday is a harpsichord conference right here. This is a place of community events and community building. Next Sunday following service, we will conduct a congregational meeting with the one item of business being to elect members to serve as deacons in the class of 2026 and for the session class of 2027. Blessed and wonderful news that early Friday morning, Alyssa Teen gave birth to boy Asa Gray Teen, 4 pounds, 14 ounces. Praise God. Father Michael, brother Eli. Alyssa is on a few weeks leave and then will be some weeks working from home. In 2 weeks, on October 20th, following service, we will be treated to an adult Sunday school class called Better Than Nothing, offered by Kirk Pastor Emeritus Clayton Cook in Knox Forum. Is he here? We want to thank him already. We'll thank him next week. Thank you, Pastor. We appreciate it. In 3 weeks, on October 27th, we will again assemble snack packs for the homeless, a community service organized by the service team, and fitting for being a Matthew 25 congregation. These days, please consider providing the elements that go in the snack packs. These are listed with opportunity to donate on Sign Up Genius. There's been a lot of progress. We're probably about halfway to our goals. The Kansas City Royals are in a divisional series with the New York Yankees. Yesterday's 5-6 loss has to be considered playoff play that we can build on. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Believe it or not, baseball just faintly has to do with the scripture I was privileged to contemplate this week. The Lord God came walking in the garden in the cool of the evening breeze. The faint connection is that probably the good Lord treasures all our sporting events and may specially favor baseball. About the Bible readings today, courtesy again of the beautiful surprises of the lectionary, we're going actually underneath World Communion Sunday to some deep stuff that we have in common, I think, with every person in the world. So it's like Big World Communion Sunday. It's a deep layer stewarded by synagogue and church. The texts are an ancient psalm and a portion of very early book of Genesis. And they are opportunity to meditate on your primary relationships, vocation, and your calling as steward of what God has made. Prayer concerns are the loss of life, the injury, and the great damage done by Hurricane Helene. For information on the Presbyterian Disaster Assistance Response or to donate to its relief efforts, please check the homepage of Presbyterian Disaster Assistance online. Leslie Young's is now 9 days after a bad fall, which resulted in a severe multiple fracture of her left arm. It's been painful. She's scheduled for surgery tomorrow. Thank you for providing care, help, food. Now let us quiet our hearts and minds and prepare ourselves for the worship of Almighty God.
Good morning. So please stand in spirit. Let us share together in the call to worship. War and injustice continue today. We gather before God, asking for connection and blessings.
We gather in hope of a righteous day.
Quiet your hearts, still your thoughts, be present.
Let us be faithful in proclamation and in the hospitality of God's table.
Come, let us worship.
Thank you.
invitation to confession. Drums of warfare beat, cities of injustice rise, and the sins of the world must be confessed and forgiven, that the world might redeem, confident of God's faithfulness. Let us make confession, saying, Heavenly parents, you made the families of the earth for benevolence to each other, that we have pursued our own cause. You made the creation of abundance for all, but in our conquest may you go without. You hear the confession of your people around the world, and with your forgiveness improve us for lives of benevolence and grace. Friends, hear the good news. In Christ, you are pardoned. Now may the God of mercy, who forgives us all our sin, strengthen us in goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep us in all life to come.
Thanks be to God. Amen.
Please be seated.
And let us pray. Where there is disaster and where there is war, loss, and devastation, be God of mercy and rescue. Help our siblings in the human family in need. Comfort those grieving, strengthen those exhausted, and shelter those who have lost home. Be specially with our ill, aged, and injured. Be specially with Leslie and Phil. Praise for your healing power and that you made, you can make well. Let it indeed be well. Thank you for Asa and for the family from which he comes. Thank you for the marriage of Michael and Alyssa. Bless Asa with every wellness. Lord, who doesn't tell us too much, but enough, and whose glory the heavens are telling, and who comes to us with goodness, now we pray as we were taught, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Good morning again.
Good morning.
I don't want you to be sleeping. Our first lesson this morning is taken from the book of Psalms, Psalms number 8. O Lord, our sovereign, how majestic is your name in all the earth. You have set your glory above the heavens. Out of the mouth of babes and infants, you have founded a bulwark because of your foes, to silence the enemy and the avenger. When I look at your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars that you have established, what are human beings that you are mindful, of them, mortals that you care for them? Yet you have made them a little lower than God and crowned them with glory and honor. You have given them dominion over the works of your hands. You have put all things under their feet, all sheep and oxen, and also the beasts of the fields, the birds of the air, and the fish of the sea, whatever passes along the paths of the seas. O Lord, our sovereign, how majestic is your name in all the earth. This is the word of the Lord.
And from Genesis, in the second chapter at verse 18, where it reads, "The Lord God said, 'It is not good that the man should be alone. I will make him a helper as his partner.' So out of the ground, the Lord God formed every animal of the field and every bird of the air and brought them to the man to see what he would call them. And whatever the man called every living creature, that was its name. The man gave names to all cattle and to the birds of the air and to every animal of the field. But for the man, there was not found a helper as his partner. So the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon the man, and he slept. Then he took one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. And the rib that the Lord God had taken from the man, he made into a woman and brought her to the man. Then the man said, 'This at last is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman, for out of man this one was taken. Therefore a man leaves his father and his mother and clings to his wife, and they become one flesh.'" This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. About these ancient writings that are so blessed, rich, positive, meaningful, influential, and more, a few basic things that may bless even more. In the midst of trial, there's a way out. Ready for a pick-me-up? How high do you want to go? Having a regular good day? It's about to get even better. You'll go on your way with more thanks and praise. Such is the power of God's word. Few basic things. Sometimes we want to know that we're special. Well, we are special. Now, I'm basing all this on an ancient song and Genesis, but listen, the stuff that is thousands of years old and cherished by the faithful north, south, east, and west, it doesn't endure if it isn't true. Special. Genesis says God gave special personal attention in the creation of us, was specially self-giving in the creation of us. This psalm says we're made a little lower than God. I mean, what are we going to do? Argue with that? We know it's true. Thank you, God. Special. Creativity, generosity, grace, and joy are ours. Also, we're meant to be pretty good at rest, as well as moving mountains when and where they need to be moved, because God's good at both, and we're only a little lower than God. Sometimes we want to know we're respected. Well, we are entrusted with God's special things. This is the word about dominion here and there in Scripture and in the Psalm. We have no particular assignment, role, or expectation laid upon us, except that we do to tend, care for, steward it all, to grow things, give attention to things, know it, name it, describe it, see to its flourishing and well-being. If we're going to do something with what God has made, shape it, we'll envision it. No one's ever thought up anything better to do. Of course we're respected. What a high, free, and satisfactory calling. And we're supposed to enjoy it all, take pleasure in it all. Oh boy, we are respected. And this pleasure, this joy, includes turning wheat into bread and grapes into wine and eating festival lamb. Sometimes we want to know we're appreciated. That's an easy one. Perhaps the crown part is figurative in crowned with glory and honor, but the rest of it is glory and honor. Absolutely, we are appreciated. Plus, the animals seem to really like us. Sometimes, all the time, we want to know we're lovable and loved. Well, it does say, the Lord God came walking in the garden in the cool of the evening breeze. Why? Just to be with us. Believable? I would think so. Not even a stretch. We're not bad to hang out with. Lovable and loved by you know who. Plus, we can always love each other. These rich old texts in front of me last week, astronomy and cosmology videos are super fun and can be super beautiful. Love them. But these texts, so much more. I mean, that companionship is the best. You see, you don't get a whole lot of that in science. Companionship is the best. Genesis chapter 2, that God wants it for us, says it is not good without. It is good with. Praise God who ordains our lives. What a created order that as human beings, we are given to each other, to survive and to thrive. So enjoy your companions. Praise God for the multiplicity of our companions. I sure want everyone to be well companioned. And who is our family? Those persons, whether individual, spouse, or partner, who fills that deep, deep desire for companionship. Sometimes we want to be assured that it's a sensible creation, orderly, but not in the sense of rigid. Well, these early scriptures celebrate the order, the design, which is full of connection, relationship, mutuality, responsibility, love, even self-giving love, and describe it all as the beginning of the praise of God. Evil is just devastation in it. But the root sense is that we are very safe in this creation. It is built that way. It is supposed to be that way. Whether it is that way is mostly up to us. Speaking of safety, the way the Bible starts is we are very safe with God. Remember that good news. Sometimes it's not this way, these ways here, the good, good, and very good, and the well companioned, which is now for a lot of people around the world, and is now, at least in some ways, for most of us. One of the ways we deal with that is with the ceremony about that, which is, the people gather to drink from a common cup in lament. Generations have been doing it. It's an act that connects us deep into the past and broadly around the world. The rite means we know things are not the way they were made to be, and the gift is that the cup is also the cup of grace and forgiveness. Sometimes we need to know it's not all about us. I tell you what, the ancients said that in their songs and in their stories. We're only a part of God's greater created order, and there's some good news in that. And in fact, the creation continues, says most of contemporary theology, which heartily studies those ancient texts and science. Sometimes we want to know what to do. Care for the things God cares about while God cares about us, says a handful of ancient texts. If we don't have a why to do this, what we are given to do, that is clear to us in all respects, then this can be done anyway by trust and in faith. So go when you go, where you go, to live in this rich, purposeful, blessed, created order and enjoy. In Christ, amen. join a great multitude at this table whose earthly years were before us in time, and a great multitude whose years are ahead. This table is around the world. To this meal, we are invited by Him who has made all things and supplies its elements. All who call on the name of Christ with trust are welcome and invited to this supper. Let us pray. Creator God, praise for you formed the cosmos in your wisdom and created all things by your power. You set us in families on the earth to live with you in faith. You gave us good gifts of bread and wine and spread this table in the world as sign of your love for all people in Christ. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ and one with all who share this meal, a great multitude from every nation. Gather your people from the corners of the earth so that we may feast with you in glory that you share, in the joy of your new creation. Let's share in the amen.
Amen.
It happened on the day in which he was betrayed that our Lord Jesus took bread, and after giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to all the disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body given for you. Eat it in remembrance of me." In the same way, he took the cup, saying, "This cup is the new covenant. It's sealed in my blood, shed for you for the forgiveness of sin. Whenever you drink it, do this in remembrance of me." Would communion servers Tabe, Brian, and Betty please come forward? Thank you. Has everyone been served who wishes to be served? This is the blood of Christ. Let's share together in the prayer after communion, unison. Thank you that we may now rise from this table where you,
God of all, have served us by your own hand, to go forth and extend your arms of peace, your loving heart, and gracious spirit to the world in the knowledge of time and horror. Grant your servants to be peace, love, and grace in your world. In Christ.
Moment of gratitude.
Yeah.
I want to thank everyone who is seated here. We gave we did an act of kindness to somebody last week. That you may continue doing that. For there is no other law that is more than love. So, thank you for answering the call to be Christ's hands and feet in the world, as this is a cue for the accompanist and videographer. A moment of gratitude. We have so much to be thankful for. We are thankful for all our ancestors and their lives as children of God. In grace, God met them where they were, so join with them and we receive many of their stories and testimonies. We are thankful for daily provisions. With these gifts, a good steward, we use them wisely. We apply them in service of others, and we enjoy them. Besides provisions for the day and means to care for others, we have belongings in the body of Christ, where every person whom God calls is welcome. God welcomes the righteous and sinful alike. With the generations that went before us, we grow in grace and gratitude. The Kirk is a place of grace and gratitude. Thank you all for your forms of generosity and support in your families, in your communities, at your church. If you are worshiping on site, we have offering plates available in the narthex. If you are worshiping with us online, there is a donation interface on the Kirk's website. Thank you for answering the call to be God's hands and feet in the world. Let us now pray to dedicate all our offerings of self. Gracious God,
you create and give more than we can ever hope to return. You share more than we could ever hope to forward along. And yet we pray, accept Jesus for love.
Every voice and
awesome and ancient texts continue to influence you and bless you. And may the Lord God come walking in your garden this Sabbath evening. God bless the families of the earth, the companions, and we bless God for the companionship of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.